In today's tale, we have a wife with a case of baby rabies. What is that, you ask? Well, you will know soon enough. I am the DM for an online game of D&D. Now, our group was composed of friends, two of which are a couple that recently got married. They are both 23. They've been my friends for quite a while, and I was the best man at their wedding, and I thought it was romantic that they were playing together. Oh boy, was I wrong about that. The DM had been playing D&D for a few years now, but it was his wife's first time playing any sort of role-playing game. She told me her character's name was Ember, a Ranger Beastmaster, oof, and even though it's a weak subclass, I had no problems with her character. Until I saw her backstory. The daughter of a noble finds herself cursed by a witch, so she must be impregnated to save herself. She hooks up with her husband's character, gets pregnant, and when the witch finds out she's still alive, she comes after her. So the heavily pregnant ranger goes on a quest to seek out her baby daddy for protection. The husband was fine with this arrangement, and since this was her first time playing, I let it slide. But aside from that, I noticed another issue. Her beastmaster had a striking resemblance to her, both in appearance and personality. She had clearly modeled her character after herself. Oh well. Both of these concessions would haunt me for the next 6 months. By the third or fourth session playing with her, it quickly became apparent that she had an obsession with pregnancy. She had reunited with her baby daddy, her husband's PC, a cleric named Lucan, and gave birth. And although they had planned to be a couple in real life, she almost immediately lost interest in Lucan, and the new mother partnered up with the bard in the group. This raised many eyebrows, but everyone so far was tolerating it. The next few sessions were full of drama. She gets pregnant, she gets really possessive of what she saw as her boy toy, the bard named Merrick, she brawls with some women who were flirting with him, threatens to kill herself and her unborn child, and also leave her first child as an orphan after a nasty breakup, pleads for me to arrange an abortion for her. Ironic because she's so pro-life in real life. At this point, the guy playing Merrick is very uncomfortable, and she has drawn the ire of all the other players. I laid a crossbolt crit on her and cause a miscarriage to relieve the discomfort of both of the players. I have a talk with her husband, and he says that she's just desperate to have a child in real life and is projecting that on her character. Baby rabies is what he not so affectionately called it. Next session, after the abortion, she tried to get with Lucan, but he's skeptical of her after that disastrous relationship with Merrick and wants to just be friends for the time being. But to my surprise, I thought his view would be a lot more negative. After asking him, he confessed to me that his wife had been pressuring him to act favorably towards her character, basically guilt-tripping him. Concerned, I spoke with her about all this, and she gave me a sob story about how she was trying her best, and she was just new to the game, and didn't know what to be expected of her. She also then tells me that none of the men in the party want to date a single mom, and almost begged me to make her a D&D boyfriend. She even sent me a sheet with specifications about what qualities she wanted for him. Being an old friend of hers, I just wanted to make her happy, and I figured since he was an NPC, there wouldn't be any drama. I was wrong about that too. The NPC basically becomes a babysitter for Ember's firstborn, and she attempts to again woo Lucan, but at this point, he's moved on and is in a romance with another NPC. After being rejected again by Lucan, she's really sad and comes to me and asks to make Ember go insane, develop a split personality so she can play a new character and still be the baby's mother. I let it slide once again because I honestly felt bad. I'd feel bad too if I was playing a Ranger Beastmaster. So, with her new split personality, she starts to woo Lucan, trying to compete with the other NPC he's currently very close with, and also decides that Merrick needs to pay for abusing her and her baby. No such thing happened. As an aside, there was in real life drama going on simultaneously. Apparently the wife was talking trash about her husband to the guy playing Merrick, a 22-year-old male, and had attempted to buy a plane ticket to go overseas and visit him alone. Merrick's player tells her husband what's going on and all the accusations the wife has made against her husband, such as him trying to cheat, all of which was determined to be lies. Merrick's player now hates Ember's player, but tells me he'll do the best he can to be civil with her. And this is where the now insane Ember wants vengeance against Merrick. Meanwhile, she is throwing herself at Lucan, and at the same time, flirting with many other male NPCs, and it comes off as crazy and desperate to everyone watching. She then creates a situation where she makes it appear like insane Ember and Lucan had been intimate, but the NPC Lucan is currently romancing catches on and calls Ember a disrespectful flirt, and the wife was so angered that she threw her phone at the wall her husband was sitting at. This upset her husband a lot and had to get some distance from her. Next session, she then moves forward with her plan to get revenge against Merrick. She intends to poison him. Instead, Merrick figures out her attempts to poison him, even after she had lied to him in real life that she had no more issues with him after their disastrous relationship, and gets herself captured. The party votes to use Greater Restoration to get rid of her insanity and the new split personality character she had made. This naturally upsets her a lot. After more sob stories, she would go on to make two more pregnant player characters who would go on and terrorize any male NPCs that they could successfully dupe, pretty much using them, cheating on them, and discarding them as soon as they gave her what she wanted, a baby. And each time, it was basically reskins of her first character, which again was modeled after her, all the while maintaining that her characters were good no matter how badly she manipulated the male NPCs around her. At this point, even her husband is sick of this, but I've been friends with her for most of my life. We've been friends ever since grade school, so even then, I was reluctant. But when she again plotted to betray poor Merrick with her fourth character, her third pregnant character, I decided enough was enough. A vote was held, and the decision to remove her was unanimous. I kicked her out of the game, and before she could vent her frustrations out on me, I cut off all communication with her. I am convinced that all of her characters were manifestations of herself and showed what she would do if she could evade consequences. Unfortunately, there's no paternity testing in D&D. Merrick's player is very relieved that she's gone, and the wife no longer bothers her husband anymore about continuing to play, and we had her replaced with one of Merrick's player's friends. Note, I realize after all this had blown over that I should have removed her from the game far earlier. I don't know if it was her manipulating me, misplaced loyalty since she was an old friend, or just weakness of character, but I've learned my lesson. Merrick's player still plays in my campaigns, and he's doing a lot better now that she's banned from our server. All this story tells me is that if you want to get to know someone, have them play D&D and see what they would do if society didn't constrain them. If you don't like what you see, then you might want to talk some things out before things go too far. But what do you guys think about this?